It's Madden NFL 24. And if it's in the game, it's in the game. It's the Kansas City Chiefs and the Baltimore Ravens. Coming up next.
With Chesapeake Bay gleaming in the distance, we are inside M&T Bank Stadium near the Inner Harbor in Baltimore, Maryland. But today, two AFC teams set to do battle. It should be a good one, as it'll be the Kansas City Chiefs taking on the Baltimore Ravens. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gauden. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Harrison Butker set to get us started. It's two AFC powerhouses, the Chiefs and Ravens, underway in Baltimore. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. A number 8, Lamar Jackson, trotting onto the field at quarterback, ready to lead this Ravens offense.
Early part of his career, defenses really had to focus on his running ability, and they still do. But now, he's turned himself into a true dual-threat quarterback. When he plants his cleats in the ground and turns it loose, good things happen downfield.
They'll run with Edwards here to begin the drive. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. Opening quarter, his opening carry of the game, and I think they'll give it to him a few more times, as they should.
You're exactly right about that. With that type of a run, you want to repeat it many times until they show signs of stopping it. I think he did his visualization exercise before this one, and they're paying off.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16-yard gain.
That's the first time he's called his own number, but he's got to be overjoyed with the results. He wasn't just going to settle for a modest gain. To me, he was determined to come through with a big message to a defense that slept on him in the pocket.
They run the option here on first and 10. And maybe the wrong read there as he's going to go down immediately. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
Well, he'd had success earlier in the drive keeping it himself. Not here, though.
And sometimes when you have that kind of success, you can fall in love with the option a little bit too much and not give the defense credit for making adjustments themselves. And that play starts to lose its effectiveness.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
You get a sense of what this game plan might be. They think they can take a few home run shots against this defense. They tried it there on the opening drive, but that ball's incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Jackson. And that's going to be incomplete. The Kansas City defense, tough to throw on there, and now it's fourth down.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off.
And that is no good. And this will remain a scoreless game.
Partner, doesn't seem like it. But that's a tough spot for a kicker. First drive of the game, and they're calling on him. He should be warmed up. He should be into the game. But sometimes It's almost like, oh, what, now already? Can't they put it in the end zone? What's going on here?
Yeah, and he's probably saying, if you can't get it in the end zone, can you give me a 30, 40-yarder? But a long one, and he can't connect. So the missed 56-yarder, and now the flip side. Good starting field position at the 46 near midfield. On first down, Mahomes. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Rice. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. Second and a couple. They fake the give. Now Mahomes. Pitch and catch here to Travis Kelce. And Kelsey's going to have a Chiefs first down as he'll get this down to the 41. 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
On first and 10, here's Pacheco. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
From the 37, they work on second and 6. Play action. Now it's Mahomes. Throw is going to be incomplete.
Partner, I came into this game eager to see how they would hold up the man coverage. And on that play, they held up quite well.
First down marker at the 31. It's third down. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And he's caught. And he'll go out of bounds. Inside the 15-yard line. 23 yards on the play.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Rice. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds right around the 7. That'll go for a gain of 7, and that will bring up second down. Here's Mahomes to throw. Touchdown! Kadarius Toney, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Chiefs are on the board first on the road here in Baltimore. Well, on that connection, it looked like they maybe had some pre-play communication. Maybe one of them noticed an area that was open to the defense to get the pass to.
When you put the time in, sometimes you have that great silent communication that you just noticed right there, because the best quarterback receiver combos in the NFL, they know how to make those adjustments at the line of scrimmage when they see something pre-play, and they got it done there.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And Hill will opt for the touchback. Baltimore set to take over here for their second possession of the game. And they were in field goal range the last time out but couldn't connect.
And it's early in the game, so I don't think that the confidence just goes entirely out of, you know, running your kicker back out there. But let's face it, some coaches have a little bit less patience for that than others. Let's see if they call the game differently now in terms of what they do on drives and not try and settle for field goals.
On first and 10, it's Jackson. That's complete. It's Rashad Bateman. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards, the final tally.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. And they run with Edwards off the option. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Here's Jackson to throw. His throw incomplete. He was waving his arms, wanted the football, but he dropped it. And that reminds me of a story you told me from your days at Tennessee. We don't need to mention the other guy's name, but when he dropped an open pass that you blew coverage on, what'd you say to him?
Yeah, it's really not right since I blew coverage, but since he dropped the pass, I said, well, maybe next time he'll just walk it out here and hand it to you. Would that be easier? He wasn't real thrilled with that
answer. That's cold-blooded. Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
Almost feels like anything you can do, we're going to try and match or do better. We've already seen one touchdown pass from the opposition. They tried to equal it on that throw.
Fourth down, and out comes Jordan Stout here to punt. Waiting on it will be Richie James. He'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward the sideline. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. Kansas City taking the field for their second drive. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. I mean, look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up two touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
Here's Pacheco to begin the drive. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first. Although his reputation as a speedy runner precedes him, it's always fun to watch him work.
It is eye-opening, isn't it? Because when you see him get the ball and just go, in addition to that speed, it helps out his blockers. They don't have to hold blocks for long because he's just going to speed right past them.
Mahomes' throw complete there to Rice. He's to the 15, and he gets it all the way down to the 3. A big play there on the catch and run, 62 yards.
Oh, big-time credit. What a play design there. They wanted to get him loose in the open field, and they succeeded. He had all sorts of room to operate in, and they finally track him down inside the 5-yard line.
After the big play, a chance to finish now on first and goal. Throwing now is Mahomes. The quick slant caught. He'll get only two there, and it's second and goal.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot, that's a big-time play by the defense.
Edwards-Helaire is into the end zone. Touchdown, Kansas City. Boy, that was a quick drive. The passing game set it up, and then the running game finishes it off.
And how about how few plays it was to get it done? But they threw it downfield and then pounded it into the end zone. And as a former defender, I can tell you, it hurts just a little bit more when they run it into the end zone instead of throwing it.
Butker on for the PAT. And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead. Just a four-play drive that time.
And it's capped off by a touchdown run from Clyde Edwards-Helaire.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Returning it, Justice Hill. The dangerous Hill now to return. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. They've been outplayed early, no question. Down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10. From the gun, it's Jackson. That's complete. It's Zay Flowers with it. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. They needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after.
Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be second down.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one because when you run him on short gains, your risk-reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
On second down, Jackson. Throw left side complete. That's Edwards. And in for the Ravens touchdown.
Gus Edwards.
64 yards. And the Ravens have got it back to within a score. They were already down two scores early. They needed something to try to stem that tide, and that certainly qualifies. A big play to get them in the end zone.
It qualifies indeed because, let's face it, they don't get something done on this drive, turn it back over. This game could be 88 and out the gate early.
What? 88 and out the gate?
Yeah.
What's that?
Well, listen, I used to hear my old man talk about it. Usually meant that thing's done.
Well, now that they got the touchdown, it's not 88 and out the gate. We still got a good game going ahead of us. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that'll make our score 14-7. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And we see James, he will not return it, and they'll bring it out to the 25.
KC's offense ready to take over. So for this offense, Charles, remember, drive one made it to the end zone. Drive two resulted in a touchdown as well. Now they'll try to make it 3 for 3.
Yeah, and you know, they told us all week that this was the plan and this is what they wanted to execute, but did they really believe it would happen this well, this efficiently? I know they'll take it, and afterwards they'll say, there was never a doubt in our minds we were going to be successful in this one.
They'll start the drive here with Pacheco.
That's to about the 28, second down coming up.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. To throw, it's Mahomes. Nowhere to go here. He lost the fumble. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble. That could have been trouble.
Through one quarter, 14-7, our score. The Chiefs with the football as we start the second quarter. So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down. As they've got it as we resume action.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw.
Throw left side, complete to Tony. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Here's Pacheco headed right. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely, pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
2 yards to go, second down.
Looking to throw is Mahomes.
Throwing the out route here, and it's complete to Kelsey.
And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens' 44-yard line. A nice pickup there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Mahomes firing complete, and he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes.
Throwing quickly there, but it's incomplete.
And their backs up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Here's second and 10.
This one to the right, caught by Valdez-Scantling. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. Here comes play number 9 now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. From the gun, it's Mahomes.
They'll check this one down to Pacheco.
They'll wind up getting just a yard out of it. And it'll be 4th down.
Always important as a defender on 3rd down to keep the play in front of you and make sure you don't give up enough space that they can make a move on you in the open field. Try as he might, he wasn't able to get to the 1st down marker. Excellent defense, good tackle.
They'll go for it. It's Mahomes. He's got his target. That's complete. And in for the Chiefs touchdown.
Rashee Rice,
26 yards.
And the Chiefs' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points.
So, Charles, that's 3 touchdowns on 3 drives, and it's just been an offensive barrage so far.
Great word, partner, using barrage right there. I'm going to add another word, if you don't mind. How about perfection? No surprise that they're leading right now. Absolute dominance throughout this ball game, and no signs of slowing down.
Extra point by Butker is on target,
and it's now 21-7. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away.
This fielded right at the goal line. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20. And Baltimore's offense set for this next possession.
So remember, Charles, last time they were out here, they scored, but they just saw the opposition score, and they're trailing right now, so they're trying to keep pace here. They need a touchdown drive.
Well, if you're a fan of offense, you're loving this, but if you're a fan of defense, this is tough to watch, and it's also tough to keep that up when you just watch your opponent march down the field on a scoring drive that lasts into double-digit snaps. You need a score here, not just to follow the momentum from your last drive, but put the onus back on your opponent. And that's what they're doing right now, swapping that onus back and forth.
And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
I certainly like what he did right there because he smartly wanted to avoid forcing anything downfield because nothing appeared to be open. Nice harmless slide there to avoid the big hit, and he gets a small gain on the play.
And they run the option on second down. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a third down.
Well, for that being an option play, there really weren't too many options available for him, were there?
No, there weren't, and at least he was able to get back to the line of scrimmage, so they didn't lose anything, but you're exactly right. Nowhere to go.
On third down, Jackson. Oh, and that is incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Here's Jordan Stout now. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. James now to return it. It'll be a 44-yard punt, six on the return. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10.
Now this offense back out and set to go for their next drive. Right now, everything they touch turns to gold. This is their fourth possession. Touchdowns on their first three possessions. I mean, this defense, they can't seem to stop them. It's like they're on skates.
Great analogy, Brandon, because they are pushing them back and winning everything at the line of scrimmage. They've just been laying down tracks towards the opposite end zone. So to themselves, all they're saying is, if we don't make a mistake, there's no way they can stop us.
That's complete to Tony. Call it a gain of six on the play, and it'll be second down. Pacheco gets it up the gut, and he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here, third and five.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them, but they did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
The Chiefs on third down. They've been okay, two for three thus far. This will be third and five. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he will have a Chiefs first down. They needed five there on third down. He winds up getting seven. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
From the 47, it's second and five. Mahomes on the give to Edwards-Helaire. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
Partner, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get them. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for him. Show him that you're supposed to get the football.
Mahomes now on first down. It's Kelce on the ground. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
He's certainly done a nice job spreading the field on this drive, and here he finds his big tight end for good yardage. And that's what you have to do. Keep defenses guessing about where you're going to go with the football.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Now Mahomes. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. Second and 10. They go back to the ground with Edwards-Helaire. And he's going to get it inside the 10 to the 7-yard line. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
Mahomes to throw on third and one. And that's caught. It's Kelce. Touchdown, Kansas City. A 7-yard touchdown grab, and the Chiefs have moved out in front by 3 touchdowns.
You got to figure down by the goal line. This is where a tight end earns his money, in the high traffic area. And he's able to work free in the middle of the end zone and grabs that one for a touchdown.
And now before we get to the extra point, remember all touchdowns do have to be confirmed by the replay official. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How's the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Butker now to add the extra point. He knocks it through. It's 28-7. That time, a 9-play drive. And it culminates in a Travis Kelce touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Returning it, Hill. The return man is Hill. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, and this is exactly why you practice a 2-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
They'll throw on first down with Jackson. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play. And it's second down.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
Little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Complete to Likely. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. That's good for a Raven first down, 15 yards there.
Now that's the kind of big play you'd like to see. This first half, it hasn't gone their way, and they could use a shot in the arm, something to perk them up a bit. And they get one here in the passing game.
Flowers going to go in motion right. They go play action now. Jackson. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
Again on second and 10, it's Jackson. He finds his man, it's Charlie Kohler. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Now following the completion, we're going to get a stoppage here for an injury. Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. To throw again is Jackson. That ball's caught. Aguilar, right side. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. They'll come up second and 7. Jackson. A quick throw there is incomplete.
They're putting together a drive here in the final minutes of the half, but the coverage has been tight all game long, and they certainly want to keep them off the scoreboard here.
So third down, they need to get to the 28 for a first. Jackson now. What a juke. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Hey, what we got? Jackson on first down.
A short one there, caught by Likely.
Short completion, just 4 yards, and it'll be second down. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. From the left hash, it's a 36-yard attempt. Tucker's kick is good, and the deficit drops now from 21 down to 18. Well, not the best first half facing this deficit, but at least they did put 3 on the board before half.
Yeah, it's a little bit like that stormy, cloudy day, and the sun peeks through just for a second. They saw the sun there. They're hoping to see a little bit more of it in the second half.
So still time for the kickoff here. 1 second to go in the half as this one is away. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome in everyone to our downtown Orlando studios in this EA Sports Halftime Report. This was an extremely one-sided first half. One team showed up, ready to go. The other's been in a daze thus far, but there's still plenty of time left for this one to tighten up significantly.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Ready for the start of the third quarter. The Chiefs have the lead and set to receive the football. And we see James, he will not return it, and they'll bring it out to the 25. The Chiefs ready to go on offense to begin quarter number three. Well, this offense, this team, they are rolling right now, Charles. They've scored on three straight possessions. You look at the scoreboard, and they pretty much right now got this thing on cruise control.
Yeah, and this is that time of game where you and I have to be prepared, right? Isn't this kind of like that empty the bucket time where you have to go into your blowout material and make sure we have some different things? That's what we're staring at right now, the way this one is going.
Mahomes now on first down. Got an open man. It's Valdez-Scantling. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. It's a first down, his fourth catch of the game after having three in the first half.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
On first and 10, here's Mahomes. Short throw hauled in by Kelce. And they're going to get this up to midfield. It'll go as a gain of 10 and a Kansas City first down.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a three-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
From midfield, here's Mahomes to Valdez-Scantling over the middle. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. 25 yards there on the catch and run. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets, because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
On first down, Mahomes. The tight end Kelce has it over the middle. And they'll get this down to the 10. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field, and just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Looking to throw is Mahomes. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. Jadeveon Clowney able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
Well, that's not how you hope to draw it up there on first and goal, CD, by taking a sack like that.
Well, they tried to be aggressive, didn't they? They didn't want to try and work their way past the goal line. They wanted it right there on that play. Unfortunately, it backfired against them. Now they have to try and pick it up here moving forward.
Really nice gain on the completion. However, still third and goal that they face now. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. Adafe Owe showing off the pass rush skills. Remember, they had the nice gain on the previous play, but they just gave a lot of it back right there on that sack.
Yeah, they get the sack, get back some real estate. Felt like the type of play that can spark a defense and swing some momentum. Almost felt like a take that type of a play, didn't it, partner?
So on fourth down, Mahomes off, Harrison Butker on for the Chiefs field goal. This a 27-yard attempt here. Butker's kick here is good. So after four touchdowns in the game for this offense, this time they're forced into taking the three.
But you did mention four touchdowns, right? So four out of five, not too bad. I think that's a pretty good record for them.
After the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. Yeah.
and able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
The Ravens offense getting ready now for their first possession of the second half. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. The drive starts with a carry by Edwards, and he'll scratch out a yard up to the 30, and that's all.
Another modest gain there on that one, and I think, Charles, you can probably pin part of the deficit on a failure on their part to really get this ground game established.
Yeah, and they've really struggled to be multidimensional in this one, having a partner, because they have to be extremely one-dimensional now if they hope to get back into this game. They'll have to do it by throwing the football and hope to have success through the air.
On second down, here's the option.
Jackson hit, and he lost the football.
Oh, and this one, he may need to go back to the drawing board. He's going to be swallowed up right away.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time, wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the gun, it's Jackson. Ball had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going.
Looks like another empty possession offensively. And you're at that point in the game where you can't afford too many more of these. So this is going to require some heavy thinking on the sideline to figure out what they can do to crack this defense.
The Ravens send their punter out now as he's on here to punt it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return. And out will come the offense as they take over. Throwing on first down is Mahomes.
That'll be caught. It's Tony. Now he's loose down the left sideline.
And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown.
Kadarius Tony,
his second touchdown of the afternoon.
And the Chiefs are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
Boy, he has been fun to watch throwing the football in this one. It's certainly not fun for that defense, though, Charles. Now up to four touchdown passes in this ball game.
Yeah, we're supposed to be neutral, but I'm feeling their pain right now because he has absolutely carved up this secondary. A clinic on how to attack a defense and take them out of the game.
Extra point by Butker is on target,
and that'll increase their lead to 28. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. The dangerous Hill now to return. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20.
The offense for the Ravens returns to the field. But we haven't exactly been treated to a nail biter in this one, CD. And if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here, maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down.
There's a nice pickup right there, and after watching that play, I'm thinking about all the lost opportunities that they've had so far in this game. But right now, just focus on continuing to move the ball the way they did on the last play.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
A little do-it-yourself run right there and a nice gain.
And I like that he knew that was about all he was going to get. So he did a nice job of protecting himself, took care of the football, took what the defense gave him. If they continue to allow him to do that, they'll find their way taking what they can all the way to the end zone.
Here's Jackson to throw. Well, that's complete to the fullback, Ricard. And this winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5 to about the 39.
Now that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
Here comes 3rd and about a foot. And they'll try and run the option to pick it up. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped.
An excellent run of 22 yards on the keeper and also a first down.
It looked like almost a miscommunication defensively, because once he decided to keep it, he had pretty smooth sailing.
Yeah, it became a question of, wait a minute, who's got the quarterback? And when you talk about miscommunication, it's supposed to be called assignment football on the defensive side of the ball. But the assignment gets mixed up. That's the end result.
And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. 2 chunk plays in a row. The last one was over 20 yards, and so is this one.
Well, maybe this offense has learned something from watching their counterparts work. I'm wondering if their coaching staff said, let's do what they've been doing the entire game, because that's worked well. This offense, they have not looked particularly good all game long. But a nice throw there for a good gain and a first down.
And the officials here going to pause the game for a second. Looks like there's an injured chief on the field.
While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment.
They work now on 2nd and 9.
Throwing is Jackson. This complete left side to Aguilar. They'll give him 4 yards there, and they're going to have a 3rd down.
In search of 4 yards here to pick up the 1st down.
On 3rd down, it's Hill. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the 1st down as he's tackled at the 2. 7 yards there. Good enough to move the sticks.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that 1st. Jackson. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sacked back at the 9-yard line. A big loss there of about 7 yards on 1st and goal. So now it's 2nd down. 3 quarters have come and gone. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Baltimore. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number 4. On 2nd down, here's Jackson. A slant route caught by Bateman. And he gets halfway home from the 10 to the 5 on a pickup of 5.
What terrifies defenses when they see slant routes thrown is that the receiver is on the move, and oftentimes he catches it and gets upfield. Does a really nice job rallying to him and stopping him for a minimal gain.
3rd and goal, trying to make that scoreboard at least a little more respectable.
Flush to his right. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Lamar Jackson, a 5-yard touchdown run.
And the Ravens get a small measure of revenge as they cut into this 4th quarter deficit.
This defense, so many things to worry about in the red zone area, but you'd have to almost think that Lamar Jackson running the football, that might be #1.
It should be #1. And in this portion of the field where things shrink a little bit, because the receivers can't run past anyone because they'll run out of real estate. You should have all eyes on Lamar Jackson when the ball is snapped and try and keep him back in the pocket.
Yeah, I don't think that they were surprised he was running it there. They just couldn't stop him, and he ends up in the end zone.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. Now this Chiefs offense gets set to go again. Well, the win for them at this point seems pretty assured. I mean, still a decent amount of time left here in the fourth quarter, Charles, but you got the football, you're up 3 scores. They have to be feeling really good about where they're at.
I love your observation skills, partner, because I think you saw them charge onto the field fired up about another chance to get into the end zone. Looks to me like this group is ready to crush any hope left on the opposing sideline, and they want to do it with some gusto, too.
And he'll go down at the 26 following a gain of 6. Now, I think we can get used to seeing more of that in this fourth quarter, especially if they're having success on the ground like they did there.
Yeah, I think back when we met with the head coach in preseason, and all he talked about was building a bully. And I think it was this situation he was envisioning, trying to ice a game, plenty of time left, but being able to give the ball to his big runner and pound away and try and finish off a game.
40 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
I tell you, they didn't give it to him much through the first 3 quarters, but when they have, he's been efficient. Maybe they ride him more here down the stretch.
Yeah, not sure it was actually in the game plan for him to have as few carries as he has, but it might play out really well for them now. As you noted, if they want to ride him down the stretch, he should have fresh legs.
And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
And he'll take this one for about 4 up to the 40.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
The Chiefs on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. Here it's 3rd and 3. They'll try for the first with Pacheco. Yeah, this is only going to be a gain of 2. He needed 3. It's 4th and 1. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the first down. Close it out.
On is the punter, Townsend, as he gets this one away.
It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and the Ravens, they'll take over. Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field.
Well, we said it at halftime that they would need a nearly perfect second half to erase that deficit that they were facing, CD. But unfortunately, the second half has pretty much been a carbon copy of the first.
Yeah, that early lead was almost insurmountable the way their opponent was playing. And, partner, they do have some good news, though. This one is getting close to being over, and they can try and hit the reset button starting tomorrow.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now 1st and 10 at their own 21. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive.
Finds his man over the middle, it's likely.
And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
His second catch, this one not quite as dynamic as his first, and it's 2nd down. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. Only a yard there on the keeper, and that's going to leave him with a third down.
But now they're in a spot that every team tells us when we have our production meetings they don't want to be in, third and long. And that's because those back-to-back running plays just didn't accomplish a whole lot.
Third and 8. Now Jackson. Eluding the pressure. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. That's George Karloftis, who fought his way through the line to bury him.
We all know he's one of the better quarterbacks in the league, but definitely not today. His team trailing by multiple touchdowns and a late sack, just a parting gift from the defense for him to take back to the locker room with him.
Here we go. It's Jackson on fourth down. Pass taken in by his big tight end.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. Felt compelled to go for it there on fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a fourth down call. Doesn't matter the distance. You still have to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. A loss of 4 that time on the sack, and it brings up second.
You can almost see all the defenders rubbing their hands together with glee because we all know they relish the chance to bring down a quarterback of his caliber. Anyone who brings him down has plenty to talk about, not just a sack, but a big win built off the efforts of this defense.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. They'll wind up getting 10 back there as it'll leave them with a 3rd and 5.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get all of it back, but now they look at 3rd down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
Here's Jackson. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he'll be brought down with a 1st down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs' 24-yard line. 12 yards to pick up there, good for a Raven first.
Well, those are the types of plays they probably wish they had made more of in the first 3 quarters. And this deficit going to be tough to overcome here in the fourth, but a nice 1st down and a pickup on that throw.
Yeah, and this is where as coaches, you're looking for effort and execution, even though the scoreboard is going against you. You want to find out who's going to fight, who's going to scrap, who's going to keep their heads up and continue to play.
That time they hit him out of the slot on the drag.
And that route takes some fortitude from the guy running it because he knows he's going through the briar patch, as I like to call it, right? He's trying to work his way through all that traffic and people wanting to put a little contact on him. Really well done.
And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. And Jackson throwing once more toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, he certainly thought he had a window to push that ball downfield, but as soon as he released the throw, the corner was there to slam that window shut.
They'll try again here from the 7 on 2nd and goal. Now it's Jackson, and it's caught. Touchdown, Isaiah Likely. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Ravens have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed, but if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably hoping for a 1-to-5-play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right, and if you have that 1-to-5-play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like,
yeah,
you know.
Doesn't
you kinda
feel right.
Exactly.
Two scores down, 3 timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And the Chiefs are going to make the recovery. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. And the Chiefs now getting set to go. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. We got to have two hands on the football here as they run on first down. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Here's Pacheco once again. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. Pacheco not going anywhere. He'll lose a couple back to the 6. Ravens going to use their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Headed straight, it's Pacheco. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 90 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
Some good strong running right there. Some power and some explosiveness just about got him into the end zone.
About a half yard from the end zone, third and goal. Here's Pacheco. And he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. Isaiah Pacheco. A touchdown run there from a yard out. And the Chiefs have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter.
Well, he'd been the workhorse on this drive, and it would have been unfair to bring someone else in to finish the job. So they go back to him again, and he delivers with a touchdown run.
Butker on for the PAT. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21 points. So that drive spanned 5 plays. And it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. From his end zone, here comes Justice Hill. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down officially at the 21. Baltimore about ready to go on offense. Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out because now it's not a total loss because, as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out-personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
This one into the hands of Aguilar. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Give him 32 on the play.
Well, as my dad would say sometimes, I'm just scratching my head here trying to figure out what was going on there defensively. How did you lose him in the middle of the field? If you're going to lose a receiver, make sure it's someone on the short side of things, not deep downfield, that can hurt your defense.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
Well, this is where reading defenses and practice time comes into play. You've got to know what you're running versus zone versus man and how to run the proper route. And they just executed that one pretty well.
One last shot for Jackson. Now he breaks free in the middle of the field. And a little bit of a consolation prize there. He's into the end zone. Won't win him the game, but they do get the score with all zeros showing.
But some fantasy players are really happy with that score.
The extra point is good, but it only impacts the final score as this game comes to a close. Well, on the one side, if you try to take away something positive from this game, they played to the final whistle, getting the touchdown there on the last play, but still, all for naught, really.
Yeah, I'd say give them points for positivity. I like that. That part is good. But I often wonder, when the game is settled and the clock has run out, do we really need to kick the extra point?
Oh, yeah. It's silly.
It doesn't make any sense to me. I know that people have explained before, well, you got to play it all the way through. Come on, this thing was done.
So that'll do it. For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. From Baltimore, so long, everybody.